in Portofino, perché nei sogni credo ancora, lo strano gioco del destino a Portofino m'ha preso il cuore.
Hi guys, welcome to another review. This one's one that I'm really excited about reviewing. It's recently become definitely one of my favourites in my entire collection. Absolutely loving this at the moment. Real good summer fragrance. I'm sitting here doing this review now, 2nd of August, and in the background there's thunder and rain, but that's typical UK. But I have been wearing this. It is a great summer fragrance. Hopefully this weather won't last for too long and I'll get some more good wearing out of it. So it's one that I've previously derided because of the cost, and it is expensive, but I'm going to have to backtrack on that because, to me personally, this is now worth every penny that I paid for it. I really do love it. So the fragrance is Neroli Portofino, as you can see. So this one's from the Tom Ford Private Blend Collection. It's a citrus aromatic and it's classed as unisex. 2011 release. The perfumer on this one is Rodrigo Flores-Roux. The most notable fragrances that he's done, in my eyes anyway, are the male line of John Varvatos fragrances, of which he's done most of, if not all of those. He's also done a lot of celebrity fragrances, so he's produced fragrances for celebs such as Halle Berry, Kylie Minogue, Hilary Duff, and also for Britney Spears. Now, there was a 2007 release of this fragrance, which was in the traditional brown Tom Ford Private Blend bottle. I don't know if they're exactly the same. I've never tried it. I know when this one came out in the turquoise bottle that it was supposed to be a limited edition, but it seems to be that this is the standard one now. So as I say, I'm not sure if they're the same or if they're different. This is the only one that I've tried. So this fragrance was inspired by an Italian fishing village called Portofino. And through history, that village has been associated with affluence and celebrity visitors. It's a village that has stunning views and landscapes, and that was what was the inspiration for the fragrance. And the town has even had a song named after it and performed after it called Love in Portofino. It was a 1950s song, and it was covered by Andrea Bocelli. And it's what featured in the intro to this video. So a bit more info. The word Neroli actually comes from the person, or rather the place where she lived, who first distilled orange flowers and made flower essential oil. Anne Marie Orsini was Princess of Nerola, and she discovered Neroli while she was experimenting with different fragrances for her wardrobe and for her baths. The word Portofino is derived from the original Roman name for the town, which was Portus Delphini, and that literally translates as Port of the Dolphins. So there's just a little bit of background about the name of the fragrance. So let's get into it and let's have a look at the presentation to start with. So first of all, we've got this beautiful turquoise box. Absolutely love the presentation of this, lovely colour. You've got your Tom Ford traditional gold logo on here. Tom Ford in gold on the top. If you pop the top off here, there's the bottle, which sits really nicely inside this gold part of the box. You have to be quite careful because when you open this box, the bottle can fall out. So there's the bottle. Beautiful presentation. Again, this is a turquoise bottle. It's supposed to be representative of the clear opaque azure sea. It's very thick glass, as with all the Tom Ford bottles. Lovely presentation, nothing on the back. You've got some sticker on the bottom here. Nothing particularly interesting. Help if it was the right way around. You've got the normal Tom Ford. See my bald head in the reflection there. But yeah, really, really lovely presentation, and one of my favourite bottles for presentation that I have. And there we go. Yeah, box and bottle, really, really nice. So let's get into the actual description, the fragrance and the notes, etc. So the fragrance was Tom Ford's, if you like, attempt to recreate the old traditional eau de cologne fragrance. But it's got the quality and the refinement of an EDP. So EDCs, as you all know, are generally fresh and light, but they don't tend to last particularly long. So this brings that fresh, light EDC quality, but adds another dimension. It makes it more of an EDP twist on it. So the notes on this one, they're not official notes. I tend to, if you've seen videos of mine before, I pick out notes from various places and go with the best fit. So in the top, you've got Tunisian Neroli, Italian Bergamot, Sicilian Lemon, and Mandarin Orange. In the mid, there's African Orange Flower. I'm not sure whether that is in there as well as Tunisian Neroli. Not sure whether both of those are in there, because that would tend to think that they smell very similar, but maybe. And in the base, you've got Rosemary and Amber. So off the top of this one, you get hit with a big blast of citrus. But I get pretty much all of the top and the mid notes right out of the gate with this one. I get Neroli, Bergamot, Lemon and Orange Flower, whether it's Neroli or Orange Flower. And although technically Orange Flower is a floral, I guess, it's not a floral smelling fragrance. Not to me anyway, it's just a clean, fresh, that Neroli clean freshness. Now, fragrance doesn't really change an awful lot. Certainly in the first hour, it's very linear. You get the different notes in there kind of popping up and disappearing, they interchange, but they're all there. After about an hour, you get Amber and Rosemary that join in. There's not a huge amount of ways to describe the fragrance or to dissect it. It's just a very clean, soapy, Neroli Bergamot fragrance. The notes will tell you exactly what you're going to get from this. With Tom Ford Private Blend fragrances, you tend to get quite a complex composition. With different stages in the fragrance. You're not really going to get that with this one. It's probably the most simple and linear private blend that I've tried. It's a sort of fragrance you probably more expect to come from a house like Creed, because it's got that really clean, fresh and almost universal appeal. It's not one that many people are going to dislike. It's definitely a happy, uplifting fragrance. If you're in good spirits, this one will lift you even higher. If you're not in good spirits, you probably want to reach for something else, because this one could be kind of like the annoying smiley person that's in your face when you just want to be left alone and wallow in your own misery. But for me, it really does do something. I get a natural high from this. I do actually get an adrenaline rush, and it really, really makes me feel upbeat and invigorated. So moving on from that, words that I've used to describe the fragrance: it's crisp, clean, fresh, invigorating, uplifting and effervescent. Purpose or occasion for this one? Well, last week I was on holiday and we took our kids to the Sea Life Centre. And it's one of those ones where you can walk through the glass tunnel and you're surrounded on both sides and above by the clear blue water and exotic fish. I couldn't really have picked a better fragrance to wear on that day, because that setting is exactly what I get from this fragrance. Fresh tropical water, not sea water, fresh tropical water with exotic fish and all of that sea life, sea plants, and just a beautiful, crisp, clean smell of nature. The fragrance for me is best suited for spring and summer daytime, but it's a shame to limit it to only getting worn for a small period of the year, so I'll probably wear this at other times as well. Performance wise, for the type of fragrance it is, the performance is really good. And you'd expect that with an EDP. I get around 8 to 10 hours longevity on this. Excuse me. And probably around 3 hours of 2 to 3 feet of projection. And again, 3 hours maybe of moderate CR. The CR isn't great, but you will get noticed, you will leave a cloud. After 3 or 4 hours, it does become more of a personal scent, but it's still detectable. I mean, sometimes I can smell this for up to 12 hours. And I know that other people get even longer out of this. So it's a really good one performance-wise. Comparisons on this. So it's been compared to 4711 by Mora and Wirtz. In fact, I've done that comparison myself in a previous video. And there is definitely a similarity, but it is just a similarity. Only to the extent that, I know, a sparkling wine is similar to a great French champagne. There's a similarity. It's been compared to Bergamotto Merino. I've also done that. And again, there's similarities, and I love that one, so I'm not going to criticise it, but the similarity, again, is only slight. And it gets compared to Mugler Cologne, a comparison which I don't really see. No matter what anyone tries to tell me, this is without shadow of a doubt better than any other fragrance that this has been compared to. In fact, it's not even comparable in my eyes. Mugler cologne's in my top 20 fragrances in my collection. This one's in a different stratosphere to Mugler cologne, in my opinion. Price wise, so retail prices in the UK are £140 for a 50ml, which I have here. This is my backup. And then you have the 100ml here, which is £210. And there's also a 250ml, I believe, decanter bottle, which is £320. I'm not sure how faked this fragrance is, but I would probably prefer to buy this one from a reputable retailer. Some in the UK, John Lewis, House of Fraser, Selfridges, all carry this one. Now, let's be clear, if you look at things literally, this fragrance isn't worth that type of money, but then again, is any fragrance ever worth the money we pay for them? It's just scented water at the end of the day. But with this, I don't care if this is expensive. I could spend £150 on a night out drinking Jaeger bombs very easily and then wake up in the morning with nothing to show for it except for a sore head. For the same price, I could have this bottle which will last me for years and is an absolute wonderful fragrance. So if you can afford it, I would say it's worth the money, but it's not a fragrance that you dive in as a beginner. It's for someone that's really, really into their fragrances. So ratings wise, we'll start with performance. So longevity, I'm going to give it 8 out of 10. Projection and sillage, a 7.5 out of 10. For actual smell, which is where this one really, really shines, this is getting 10 out of 10 for me for smell. It's as close to perfect as you can get, in my opinion. So this one is going to mark the inauguration of my perfect 10 club for overall score. Overall rating for Tom Ford's Neroli Portofino, for me, is 10 out of 10. So that's the end of the review, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks very much for watching, and I will see you very soon with another video. Cheers.